938 Live. This is Talkback.
And welcome into Talkback right here on 938 Live. Is enough being done to put a sparkle into the Christmas shopping season in Singapore? Every year, many people, both residents and tourists, make an annual pilgrimage to Orchard Road, well, pilgrimage, so to speak, to see the festive lights. It's an opportunity, of course, to assess how the new lights match up to those on display in previous years and to get into the Christmas mood. But with more big malls opening up around the island and exciting alternatives overseas, does Orchard Road still hold its traditional appeal? Now, for more than 30 years now, that's right, 31 years actually, Christmas in Singapore has been marked by what has now traditionally become the Orchard Road Christmas light-up. And this year, the lights, goodies, presents and Yuletide joy is going to flow even greater, with greater significance, with events to commemorate 50 years of tourism in Singapore. Christmas on a great street. Well, that is the name and the collaboration between the Orchard Road Business Association and the Singapore Tourism Board to bring special elements into the Christmas celebrations in our premier shopping area. Now, joining us this morning is Stephen Goh. He's Executive Director. And we have Adine Low. She is the Deputy Executive Director, both of the Orchard Road Business Association. Thank you very much for both of you coming in this morning.
Good morning, Singapore.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, Singapore. You always wanted to say that, I bet,
yes.
Stephen.
Yes.
Okay. Now, Steve, how important is the Christmas shopping season for retailers in Orchard Road?
In fact, the Christmas season is the most important season for most retailers on Orchard Road. 30% of their annual sales actually are transacted during the last 2 months of the year.
30%?
So, yes.
Wow.
And in fact, they plan the merchandise far back as 6 to 7 months ago, just to prepare for the season. So it's a very, very important season for all the retailers on Orchard Road.
Now, what is your organization doing to ensure that Orchard Road retains its position as a premier shopping destination for residents and tourists?
I think the fact that we have to organize this signature event for the year, the Christmas on the Great Street,
right,
is our most important and signature events. And so this event has actually attracted a lot of international attention as well. Wherever we go for conferences, you know, everybody is very interested how we organize the Orchard Road Christmas light up.
Wow.
And for most Singaporeans, I think when we start the Christmas light up, we signify the start of the season for Singapore.
Absolutely. I mean, as I said, this has been happening for now more than 30 years.
That's right.
And I think a lot of Singaporeans actually do look forward to the Christmas light up.
I'm sure.
But as I mentioned also, but you do have rivals, so to speak, coming up in the heartlands, right? And how is that shaping up as well?
I think the suburban mall has served its purpose, and I think most residents stay near, close to the suburban mall. They usually go to the suburban mall. But Orchard Road always plays a very special heart in the mind of Singaporean. When it comes to Christmas, they always think of Orchard, because Orchard is not just about a street, but it's actually a collection of shopping malls. And we do have 7 great departmental store on one single street, you know. Just to mention that Metro just opened their biggest single store on Orchard Road, and then you have Robinson, you have Isetan, you have Takashimaya.
Right.
So these are all favorites, place to shop for gift for the season.
I mean, okay, somehow or other, you know, with the festive season, people seem to be a little bit more liberal as well with their spending.
Mm.
But is, I mean, with, you know, the economy not doing so well, do you expect sales to be as good as before?
I think this year, my personal opinion is that it will be a moderate year for us, because taking into factors of the event around the world and
yes,
the strong Sing dollar as well. So I believe this is a joyous occasion, so we hope for the best.
Okay, so the question is now, will the lights and activities have an effect on your spending? 669-11938 is the number. We'd like to hear from you and tell us whether, you know, where you are going shopping this year. Does it really matter where you buy your Christmas gifts and food? And what would the draw interest for you be to go down to Orchard Road? Okay, people say, yes, there are jams and car parks are full to the brim. I think actually that's all a good sign, right?
That's right, yeah. So sometimes traffic jam are good for us because it's a good sign that, you know, people are coming.
That's right. I mean, that's true. So we'd like to hear from you, 669-11938. Now, how much pressure is there, you know, for you all to come up with something bigger and better every year? I'm sure it's not easy.
In fact, within the organization, every time when the president turned on the light, we already start planning for next year. In fact, 2015 Christmas preparation already in place. That we
really?
Took a long time. Yeah, we start talking to designer, potential designer, talking to contractor, how to improve the installation, the maintenance. So there's a big thing behind the scene. Yeah.
Now who pays for the lights and the decorations and all?
I think
that?
This is a collaboration between Orchard Business Association with Singapore Tourism Board as well as our sponsor Hitachi. Mm. In fact, Hitachi has been the great sponsor for the past 24 years. You know, and
what has their contribution been?
The contribution by Hitachi is not just contribute toward the installation of the light. They use this plate. In fact, for the past 30 years, ComChess and National Council of Social Service are using Christmas Light Up as a platform to launch their charity drive.
That's
in
right.
In fact, this year, we are extremely happy because being the 50th anniversary of Singapore.
That's right.
Next year, and we work with ComChess. We raised more than 1.5 million for ComChess using some of the set pieces donated to them. So government matching dollar for dollar. So we actually raised about $3 million.
Wow. Okay. So is that, you know, continuing for the whole Christmas season?
This is a special year for us. So we have to see what happens next year. Yeah.
Okay. Now, the thing is, how are people really seeing, you know, the Orchard Road light up as sparkling as it used to be? I mean, they're always looking for something, and you know, Singaporeans are always looking for something new. Adine, what can you tell us?
Well, you know, in fact, this Saturday, the Singapore Tourism Board celebrates Tourism 50 with a Christmas themed carnival on Orchard Road. So this is part of Pedestrian Night on Orchard Road, which is a free for all access event. There'll be performances by local artists, an outdoor movie screening, bouncy castle, balloon sculpting, and face painting for children. So we're inviting everyone to bring their families down to Orchard Road.
Okay, so it's very family targeted, right? And
yes,
skewed.
That's right, yeah.
Okay, but I mean, the thing is now, so that's family. Of course, you know, once you have teenagers growing up and they say, no, I don't want to be with mum and dad, and, you know, it's not so cool to be with them. So do you have something for the teenagers?
Oh, yes, hip-hop performances. We have Jack and Ray. We have dancing. I think that's going to be samba, Santa samba performances.
Really?
As well. Yes, this Saturday.
And so which part of Orchard Road is this going to be?
It's from Ion Orchard all the way down to Paragon. So the entire stretch will be closed to vehicular traffic.
All right.
Yeah, but we want to remind all motorists that all our car parks to the shopping malls from Ion, Paragon, Wisma Atria, Neon City, they all remain fully accessible. So please continue to drive to Orchard Road.
Okay, so continue to drive. Or, of course, you can always take the MRT,
yes,
which is available. And you are not going to get stuck in that jam. The thing is, I mean, sometimes, and I know, Stephen, what you mean, because when you say jams are good, my family and I, we purposely get caught in the jam so that we can take in the lights.
Absolutely.
And looking at, you know, look at all the decorations that are going, you know, that are out there. And tell me this, there's going to be a competition, I believe.
Yes.
Right? For all the outlets. Can tell us a little bit about that?
I think the competition are very, very keen and very strong because year on year we are facing different challenges. In fact, we do see the increase in online shopping as well. Besides the competition from individually from regional as well as from all the suburban shopping mall.
Yes.
But these are part and parcel of doing business. So that's why we are focusing more now on software programming. Not only just within the organization, we also work with third party content provider. For example, the Celebrate Christmas in Singapore. So this is the 11th year they come down to Orchard Road. So there will be a mass caroling even on the Christmas Eve. And in fact, starting from 18th of December, they have a nightly performance, you know, on Orchard. And
90 performances?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow.
90
so,
performances.
19, okay.
Yeah, that's right. So I think it's important that we have to leverage on our strength working with third party, working with our stakeholders. In fact, if we go to different shopping malls, they do have individual shopping programs as well as to engage the children, engage the shoppers. Yeah, just to enhance the shopping experience.
So everybody is working hard to bring in the customers, right? Yeah. So 669-11938, we'd like to hear from you and tell us whether or not the sparkle is still there for you at Orchard Road. Is there a reason for you to go down to town, get caught in the jams, get caught in car parks that are full, you know, driving around and looking for the car lot? For some of us, you know, it's all part of the fun. You know, it's all part of the atmosphere when you get caught up there.
That's right.
But the thing is, are you looking for something different? Are you looking for something fresher? You can always call us here on 669-11938. In the studio with us is Stephen Goh. He is Executive Director. And we have Adine Low. She is the Deputy Executive Director of the Orchard Road Business Association. Now, does a bigger light up mean better business for retailers?
As I say that we trying to do our best year on year.
Yeah.
And of course, a bigger light up is not just the infrastructure, the lighting, but I think more and more we are looking at the software programmings to make the whole Christmas season an enjoyable season for everyone. So a bigger light up, which means also a bigger budget. So we also seeking out more opportunity to work with sponsor to bring in different interesting programs to enhance the Orchard Road experience.
That's a good thing. You talk about sponsors. Somehow or other, year after year, it seems to be the same sponsors coming in. How do you encourage, or how can you try and encourage to bring other sponsors to come in, other people to, or other organizations? We have so many multinational companies in Singapore. How can we get them to be part of this celebration? And also, I mean, Christmas, the Orchard Road Christmas lineup has always also been connected to charity giving.
That's right.
The Comchess.
That's right.
So how can we get more to come in and join in?
I think Orchard Road Light Up is a history for us as well. So Hitachi has been our long time partner. So we are very happy to collaborate with Hitachi, our main sponsor,
mm-hmm.
as well with our, even our MasterCard is also chipping
right.
in to help us. And in fact, where else can you find on the Great Street that 10 shopping mall come together to do one Orchard Road promotion?
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the promotion is still ongoing. You know, if you spend $300 using MasterCard, you can be rewarded with $30 a voucher. So that's
right.
very attractive. So for the participating mall, you just go there, you shop, you can get rewarded.
And I also hear that you could also be chauffeured in a limousine.
Yes, exactly. So this is a priceless experience. So be spotted, you know, I mean, by MasterCard personnel. Who knows? You will be sofa driven by a limousine home, you know, after the great shopping. Yeah.
All right. So yeah. So you don't have to carry all those bags, and you have a much larger car to bring in all the shopping bags that you carry along.
That's right.
All right. 669-11938. We'd like to hear from you after sports and news coming up on 938 Live. For more than 30 years now, Christmas in Singapore has been marked by what has now traditionally become the Orchard Road Christmas Light Up. And this year, the lights and goodies, presents and Yuletide joy will flow with even greater significance with events to commemorate 50 years of tourism in Singapore. But now, are all these festivities enough to put a sparkle into the Christmas shopping season in Singapore? Are the lights and activities going to affect your spending and affect what you decide to buy for your loved ones as well? Will it also affect maybe the gift of sharing, because the Comchest is also active during that time on Orchard Road, raising funds for the underprivileged? In the studio with us is Stephen Goh. He is Executive Director, and we have Adine Low with him. She is Deputy Executive Director of the Orchard Road Business Association. Stephen, let's talk about what's going to be happening on Christmas Day itself. I believe a concert is being prepared.
That's right.
Just let us fill us in on what's happening.
In fact, we are very happy to work with Celebrate Christmas in Singapore. So for the past 10 years, they have been closing also on the Christmas Day to do a Christmas concert. In fact, the activity will start right after 1 p.m. They have some fringe activity lead toward grand concerts in the evening about 7:30.
Oh, wow.
And these are all the different performances from the regional groups that come in and to perform and sing Christmas carol, dance and musical performance.
And how long is the road going to be closed for?
The route will close from 1 p.m. Until about 1 a.m. in the morning because it's to restore the route back to normal.
Okay. Talking about that, this Saturday as well, Orchard Road is going to be closed, right? Adine, okay, you can fill us in on that.
Well, in fact, this Saturday, the Singapore Tourism Board celebrates Tourism 50 with a Christmas-themed carnival on Orchard Road. Now, this is part of Pedestrian Night on Orchard Road, mm-hmm. which is a free-for-all-access event. There will be performances by local artists, an outdoor movie, which will be screened, bouncy castle, balloon sculpting, and face painting for families. So bring all your children down to Orchard Road this Saturday.
Would there also still be the usual buskers and, you know, ice cream vendors?
Yes, buskers, ice cream vendors, yes, on the pedestrian mall, not on the road itself, but on the pedestrian mm-hmm. mall. And then, of course, we also have local artists coming down to perform.
Oh, okay. Yes. Now, tell me, how do you work with the buskers? Do you try incorporate them into this whole celebration? Many of them are independent, I know.
In fact, most buskers are licensed by the National Art Council.
Right.
So they do go through auditions and so they do go through a selection process. And so we do work with the National Art Council to have this group of buskers, but they are not controlled in any way scheduling. So it's quite organically been programmed in such a way that they found the crowd, they will come here and they add on to the festive mood.
Well, that's nice because, you know, it's organic and they just add on to that mood. Now, 669-11938, we haven't heard from any of you. It'd be nice to, I know many of you are on holiday, I suppose, with the kids and all that. But tell us, does Orchard Road still sparkle for you? And because many of you also have that opportunity, you know, not to go down into town because in the Heartlands, we've also got malls that are new malls as well that have opened up and some of the older malls have also been spruced up. So I'm sure every year, Stephen, you and your committee has to think of new things to come
exactly.
up for Christmas. Just give us an idea of where you get your ideas from.
Of course, the idea is not just from within the organization itself. We do receive feedback, you know, both from residents as well as international friends. And we also work with government agency. So to design a Christmas light like this is not as easy as you've seen, you know, because public safety, design considerations, budgets, stakeholder expectations. So there's a whole lot of considerations.
What is the main feedback that you have received, say, particularly from Singaporeans? Singaporeans, we are always very critical of anything that is, you know, homemade or done at home. So what's the feedback been from
I think the attitude that we have adopted, we are very open to receive feedback from the public. But however, whichever design that we selected, we can't please everyone.
For sure.
So with having factored into all these considerations, we just put forth the best light that as we can every year.
Okay, I think that's really the best that you can do. Put your best foot forward. But where do you get your ideas? I mean, do you go overseas sometimes, and do you collaborate with other foreign groups?
Of course, we do study trip to study the international lighting design all over the world. And however, because of our tropical weather, so a lot of consideration go into the material selection as well. So we can't put up material which are degradables. And there's one year we're trying to be eco-friendly. We put in some degradable material and it didn't turn out well because after 2 weeks, you know, because of the harsh weather,
right.
the sunlight and the
and
heavy
the rain.
Intense of rain,
yeah.
And the material were degenerated. So all these consideration has taught us that we are slightly different because we are a tropical country. So in comparison to Japan, to Europe, to America, yeah. So the type of lighting that we choose and has to be slightly warmer, and unlike in the Europe, it's very cool, and so we don't have snow.
Yeah.
So, but you can go down to Tanglin Mall. In fact, they're trying to create some artificial snow.
That's right. Yes.
For the children. So,
correct. So I think every year, I mean, my kids, when they were younger, that was one of the highlights of going out. Yeah, it still is. It still is. Okay. Some people have said, you know, we should have a countdown party to end Christmas with a bang at New Year's Eve. What are your thoughts on that?
We have some interested party approach us to organize a countdown party. But however,
this year?
Year on year that people approach us ever since the Swing Singapore days.
That's
you know?
Correct.
Yeah, we hope to bring back some days, but I think working with our government agency, there are certain considerations because of crowd control, public safety.
Right.
And we'll try our best. Someday we'll bring it back.
All right. Well, okay. So that's a promise. Someday we'll bring it back. Well, thank you very much, Stephen. Stephen Goh is Executive Director, and Adine Low, she is Deputy Executive Director of the Orchard Road Business Association. Thank you very much for joining us, and in advance, Merry Christmas to both of you.
Yeah, Merry Christmas
to you. Merry Christmas to you too.
Thank you.